faster than I can encode it. I've already lost two processors. They keep burning out.
Please, I love you. You need to get out of there. It's not safe.
I need you, Steven. I need you here. I can open the gate manually. I can let you in.
It's too dangerous. You don't understand what's happening
out
here.
No, you don't understand. We can solve this. We can find a way. I just need more power. I need to amplify the signal, and I can't do it on my own. You saw the opportunity. You ran the numbers, remember?
We're responsible for all this. You and me.
It's not just you and me anymore, though, is it?
Jesus, Kate, you're trying to talk to it, aren't you? Kate, you can't.
Steven, I have to.
Completely dead. It won't start.
It's only a short walk to the camp. I think we should split up. You go and fetch Rachel. I'll go back to the village and find Evie.
I don't think we should split up.
I don't want to either, Charlie, but we've got to. I'll meet you back at my house later on, okay? We can talk properly then.
Why won't you tell me what happened?
No, actually, you should stay at the camp tonight. Come find me in the morning. Bring Rachel back. She's going to need her mother.
Meg.
Just take care of her.
Meg!
What is it, Charlie?
Nothing. Just be careful.
I will, I promise. You as well. I'll see you later on.
Why on earth are you there? Why aren't you calling from home?
It's hard to explain. I'm having to move around to follow it. When it finds a suitable host, it begins to amplify. Sorry, I'm not making much sense.
They're talking about flu and a quarantine on the radio, but this... I know you're not that kind of doctor, but it all just sounds really weird.
We don't know exactly what it is yet, but it's got something to do with the other night.
Stephen, your face, the mark. Do you think you're infected?
It's not a disease, Lizzie. It's something else. There's something Kate said about patterns. I can't grasp it clearly yet.
Okay, come over. Have some lunch. We can talk properly. Have you spoken with Kate?
Well, she's locked herself in the observatory. She's buried in the data. But it's already out here in the world. I need to see how it adapts.
How what adapts? Stephen, try to explain.
Lizzie, listen. Be ready. I need to go. It's moving again. I'll call you later.
Physical changes are evident. Although the butterfly burn is now faded, I can clearly see the change in my pores up close. As I record these words, I can feel myself hearing them as if for the first time, as if I'm both speaker and listener simultaneously. I am a scientist. I can only deal with the evidence I have. And this points in one simple direction. It's not in the observatory. It's in me.
Do you think she'll like it?
It's in an awful state, Stephen. I don't think
so. It'll be an adventure. It'll mean putting down roots here, maybe a family.
Are you sure she wants children? What, to stay here? It's not her place, you know.
Don't start that again, please.
I mean, she's ambitious, love, and she's, well, older. She's not going to want to stay cooped up at home looking after the kids.
Is that how you felt about me?
Oh, stop it, Stephen. That's not what I meant, and you know it. I'm just saying you should make a choice. If it's a family you want, well, you know how much Lizzie wants a family.
Jesus, Mum, I didn't come here for marriage guidance. I just asked what you thought about a fucking house.
Stephen Appleton, language!
Sorry, it's just that you have to understand, Kate is the most brilliant, extraordinary, wonderful person I've ever known. She's like no one else. The way she looks at things, it's like she has whole worlds inside her head. I don't think you or anyone really understands that.
you know the protocol?
That doesn't matter now. It's figured out how to circumvent the telecommunications blackout.
What?
I didn't think it could. Kate understood. She saw how adaptable it was. How smart.
Jesus Christ, you're talking about it like it's alive.
You have to assume that everyone here is infected.
We can't know
that. We're infected. It's killed all the birds, and now it's in us. It's trying to leave the valley any way it can. The quarantine is not enough. You've got to remove the carriers. You've got to cut off its energy source, its food.
I've already told you, Stephen, I'm not going to water
you
an airstrike.
You have to. Now it knows we're onto it, it's going to keep on spreading as fast as it can.
The quarantine and blackout will hold it in check. They've cut all of the phones out of the valley, so it's only you communicating out now.
Are you listening? It's figured out ways around it. Radio waves, something. All of the lines are cut, but the phones are working anyway. You've done all the right things, but it's not enough. You've got to stop it before it adapts again.
Stephen, my family, my wife and kids.
You know perfectly well what you've got to do.
I can't do it. Don't ask me to do it. You're asking me to sign their death warrant, my own family.
Damn it, don't you think I'm aware of that? I'll still be here when you drop the fucking stuff. Don't you lecture me about sacrifice, you spineless little shit. If you're so full of ideas, you come here and try dealing with it. Tell them the time when we had a choice is over. Tell them to do it. You've got to do it now. It's all over the valley. Don't you get that? This isn't some abstract thing. Whatever came down into the tower has got out. They've quarantined the whole valley.
It's right here in the observatory.
It's out in the world. It's adapting and spreading. Do you understand?
No, we can't turn it away. It's come too far.
Kate, people are disappearing. Shut it down now.
No. If you won't help me, I'll do it on my own. I'm gonna route all the power back through Tower 6.
Kate!
Wait. It's trying to break through again.
Kate! Wait!
Thank you.
kick. What do you want me to say? You knew what you were getting into.
Really?
Well, I'm sorry we don't measure up to your exacting standards, Dr. Collins. Maybe you just need to give us ordinary humans a break.
What? Ordinary humans like Lizzie Graves? Did you really think that I wouldn't find out? Frank told me. Or did you forget there's one person in this shithole who actually talks to me?
Kate, it was just a dream.
Don't bother, Stephen!
Oh, for Christ's sake. Kate, slow down.
You were engaged to her, Stephen. You nearly married her.
Oh, come on, it was just a drink.
Then why the hell did you lie to me about
it? Because I knew you'd be mad and then it would end up in a row. You wanted to focus on the event tonight.
Oh, so you were actually doing me a favor. Wow, I guess I just forgot to say thank you. Do not treat me like I'm an idiot.
You're overreacting. I know you're stressed.
Just don't. You keep away from me tonight. I'm not gonna let you ruin this for me.
Kate, come on, this is crazy.
Pressure in my eyes again. I can't move my legs, can't feel my face. When I collapsed, the light was waiting for me there. Caught me, lowered me here. Now it's pooling around my feet, watching me. The printers are spewing out page after page of zeros. It's frightened, too. It'll be okay. I'll look after you. It's alone. It's scared. Oh, it's traveled so far. It's okay. I can help you. We can be together now. 10 seconds to signal fusion. We can be together. 3 seconds.
Have they closed the tunnel?
There's no trains. I've put up a sign.
The tunnel, Howard. Is it closed?
I think so. I don't like it. It's not right at all.
Stop whining. It doesn't help anyone. Did you know you're bleeding?
Oh, it's this headache. It's just killing me. I haven't had a nosebleed like this since I was a kid.
But you've not been to the village?
No, I've been here the last couple of days or at home. I've only spoken to Clive at the EMC on the phone. Well, tried to anyway, but with all the crossed lines...
But no direct contact with any other people?
No, no one. What are you talking about? What's going on?
It's the pattern. It's adapted again. It doesn't need direct contact to transfer. It's using the phones!
What do you mean, direct contact? Stephen!
Hello? Hello, is there anyone there? Can anyone hear me? Clive? Clive, it's Stephen Appleton. Are you there? Can you hear me? Over. Come on, Clive, where are you? Damn it! Kate, it's Stephen. Come in Tower 6. Kate, are you there? Kate? Anyone? Hello? Can anyone hear me? This is Dr. Stephen Appleton broadcasting from within the quarantine zone. Can anybody hear me? Over.
You're a daft old bird walking all the way out here for it. You know Charlie would have dropped it off.
What, and have that stinking great lorry of his poisoning my birds? He shouldn't be driving it on these lanes. It's a hazard.
I think he was hoping he could have a word with you about Frank.
There's nothing to say.
Oh, listen, Wendy, they might all be scared of you, but that's not going to work with me. You're 68 years old. Grow up. Talk to Frank.
How dare you speak to me like that? Give me my bird feeder right now.
Promise me you'll drop by and see your brother.
Megan Holloway, give...
Not a chance. Promise me. It's for your own good and you know it.
You are a shamelessly manipulative and difficult woman. It's no wonder Charlie adores you so much.
No wonder I do what?
No wonder you never finish what you start. I thought I told you to check the incoming stock orders. Wendy, one bird feeder for you. I'll tell Frank you'll stop by.
Oh!
Charlie, stop mooning around and stick the kettle on. Make yourself useful.
What are you doing here?
You thieving bastard. I knew it was you.
Listen, take everything you need. But then you have to leave. You don't understand. You can't be near me.
Painting your stupid little pictures. Stealing food. You always were a little prick.
Please, every second we're in proximity makes it worse. I'm a primary conduit.
You're a fucking disgrace. Come here.
Sam,
don't touch me. Get off.
What's going on?
Come in here.
Lord. Jesus,
get off.
Sam.
Over us. Thinking you're so much better
Sam,
than the rest of us.
No physical
you
contact.
You and your stupid fucking
Sam,
missus.
Stop
She's
it.
Better than any of you.
Sam. Sam.
Is he?
Meg, please.
Don't come near me.
Meg.
Charlie.
Meg, wait.
Don't touch me.
Meg, please, you have to understand. It was an accident.
Get off
her. Let go. Let's just go.
Charlie. You have to understand, it was an accident.
Just leave him. Leave him!
What have you done, Appleton, you bastard?
Come on, Charlie, let's just get
Charlie,
out of here!
Charlie, please!
Special Master's house. Howard Lantham speaking.
Howard, it's Clive. Clive Smith. I need you to listen to me and not ask questions or interrupt. Can you do that?
Yeah, I can. But why are you calling?
The Emergency Measures Committee is imposing a quarantine around the valley. We've got an influenza outbreak in the village. We're suspending rail services, and we're also going to be shutting down the roads for a bit. You're going to be dealing with some anxious people, Howard, so you need to explain it's all under control, and we'll be back to normal in a few days.
All right.
Open up the emergency store. There's posters and boards, along with a bunch of stuff that hasn't been used since the war. Grab anything you think might be useful. I need you to close up any unoccupied buildings, put posters up, that sort of thing. Make sure everything is all squared away and shipshape. You are a military man, I'm sure you understand that. Everyone doing their bit, following their orders. All right?
All right, I think.
Good man. I knew we could count on you.
Ah, Jesus, Blaze. What the hell was that?
Repeating over and over to myself in the dark, eating cold food from a can with my fingers. My name is Catherine Collins. I am Catherine Collins. As if I can force the world to acknowledge my existence. Time has ceased to exist in any real terms. I'm reduced to marking off the days on the walls, like a cavewoman.
You look well.
I don't. But thank you. You do. How are you settling in?
Nothing changes around here. I mean, it's great to be back. It still feels like home, I suppose. In a funny kind of way.
It's been a long time, Stephen. Last time you saw me, I could still walk properly.
You look pretty good to me.
Stop it.
For what it's worth, I'm sorry about how things worked out.
Or didn't.
Or didn't, right.
Do you think you made a mistake leaving?
My mum tells me it's never too late to change things, to put things right.
Funny. It's just what she said to me the other day. I have been wondering what she meant by that.
That's embarrassing. Sorry.
Maybe I should go.
Why?
Stephen, we're both married. I don't think this is a good idea.
What isn't? We're just two old friends having a drink, that's all.
Thank you.
is Catherine Collins, recording for posterity. It's all over. I don't know how long I've got. Whatever he did, whatever the planes were carrying, it's burning my lungs. Probably some kind of nerve agent. I suspect it's only exposure to the pattern that has kept me alive this long. I'm making my way to Tower 6. I'm going to fuse the signals from the optical array. I just hope I can make it.
Darling Stephen, I don't know if you'll ever listen to this. Maybe you've decided to stay with Kate, and I can't blame you for that. But I can't wait for you either. I've got to think about the baby. And, well, I should have left a long time ago. I've run out of excuses for not leaving now. But I do love you, Stephen.
And I hope you find peace one way or another. Oh, there's planes coming.
When I was a kid, my dad found a fox. It had been hit by a car and couldn't walk anymore. My mum went spare, of course, made him keep it in the shed. He was already slipping away from us then. He spent hours with that fox, telling it all about Italy and the villages they bombed there. I was jealous, I think. The fox got more of my dad than I did. But it was dying, that was clear. So one day, I snuck out, took it a sandwich for food. I was only 8. When it bit me, I remember the anger, the shock, the hurt. Running in, screaming from the garden, my mum panicking about rabies. My dad beat it to death with a spade. I found him crying. "I'd done it, Ken, son." That's what he said. "I'd done it, Ken, it was hurting you. That's just a poor, dumb, dying animal. It doesn't know it's hurting us. Christ help us, it's left the valley. It's everywhere now. It's been 3 hours since the planes went over. I haven't been able to reach anyone on the shortwave. I'm beginning to think I may have made a terrible miscalculation. There's no one left. Just me. You know what this is? What I'm gonna do? You want light? Fine. I'll give you light. After me, there's no one. You'll be all alone again. Forever. Like before. You've taken everyone I've ever loved from me. You've made me do things I never even thought I was capable of. But if you think I'm coming with you... Kate? Wait. Stop. Kate?
This is Catherine Collins. I don't know if anyone will ever hear this. It's all over. I'm the only one left.